to 6. Now question number 7. Question number 7, question asks to find the additive inverse of complex number. Okay, additive inverse is very simple. Okay, I'll just give you the idea, then do by yourself. Suppose complex number z equals to a plus bi, then additive inverse means whose sum must be 0. Then additive inverse of z equals to minus z. That means just we need to change their sign. Okay? You need to change the sign, so I'll give you idea. Suppose z equals to minus 2 plus 3i. Then additive inverse of z equals to 2 minus 3i. First you need to change the sign. Minus is there. Okay? Plus is there, change to minus, because their sum must be 0. Additive inverse means sum of numbers and its additive inverse there equals to 0. Okay, their sum must be 0. And it's very simple. Thus, question number 7, complete by yourself, is very easy. Okay, just we need to change the sign of the complex number. Now, next question. Question number 8. Question number 8. Question asks to find the multiplicative inverse of each of the following complex number. Multiplicative inverse. Okay. Multiplicative inverse. Okay. I'll give you the example. Suppose complex number z equals to x plus y I there. Then multiplicative inverse of z equals to 1 upon z. Okay, this is a multiplicative inverse. Now suppose z equals to I minus, sorry,
change its sign, then
duplicative inverse of that is reciprocal of x. Okay, reciprocal of that expression, and the expression is the complex form and denominator, simplify it and remove. Okay, if the question is complex form, first simplify and get the z. After getting the simple form of z, simple form, this is standard form of z, then get the multiplicative inverse. Okay, if the expression is complex, don't get the multiplicative inverse directly. If you want to do, you can do it. Otherwise, first make the expression simple. After making the expression simple, then get the multiplicative inverse. Okay, now this is for question number 8. Okay, I am going to do one example for multiplicative inverse. That is from your exercise 9b, question number 8, sub question 9. Okay, question number 8, sub question 9. 2 plus 3i multiply 3 plus 2i multiply I divided by five plus I. Now the question is complex form. Okay, now not in standard form. First simplify it and convert into the standard form. That is, that equals to a plus bi or x plus yi. After converting into simple form, then get it multiplicative inverse. Okay, now I will show you by doing this question. This is multiply the numerator. Okay, multiply the numerator 6 plus 4i plus 9i plus 6i square. Then one more I is there, divided by 5 plus I. Then that equals to 6 plus 39. I square means, now replace this I square by its value. I square means minus 1, and plus minus 6i. So 6 only, I square is minus 1, 6 multiplied with I divided by 5 plus I. Okay, then this plus 6 and minus 6, their sum is 0, that's why we're canceling it. Now take this I and multiply the rest terms. Okay, and that equals to 13i multiply I is 13 I square divided by 5 plus I. 13i square, okay. 13i multiply I is 13i square. Again, replace this I square by its value. Now, then that equals to minus 13 divided by 5 plus I, because I square means minus. Now we convert it into simple form. Now get its multiplicative. Okay, multiplicative inverse of z equals to reciprocal of this, and that means reciprocal of this function 5 plus I divided by minus 30. Now separate each numerator, okay, denominator of each numerator, separate denominator of each numerator, and this is equals to find the one inverse. If the equation is complex form, first convert it into simple form by doing the simplifications. Okay, after converting into simple form, get its reciprocal, that means multiplicative inverse. Okay, okay, let me see one more question. Question number 9, question asked to find the simplification. Okay. Question asked to find the simplification. Let me do one simple question. Question number 9, sub question 2. Okay. Question number 9, sub question. Sub question 2, this is very simple. Minus 49 divided by 25 multiplied minus 1 divided by 9. Just first remove this negative sign. Okay, under root of negative, under root of negative equals to root a. Just use this properties of imaginary number, then remove this minus sign from root. Okay. Now this is equals to 49 by 25 I and multiply with 1 by 9. Now get this square root. The square root of 49 is how much? The square root of 49 is 7 by 25 I multiply. Okay, this is multiply 1 divided by 3 I. Now the product is 7i square divided by 75. I square means minus 1. Now replace this I square by its value. This is minus 7 by 75. So, sorry, I wrote a mistake. This is 5. Okay, square root of 25 is 5. And this is 50. And this is 50. I think you got the idea how to simplify. Okay. First, remove the negative by using the complex property. After that, get the root and multiply it. Whatever you get, that is our final answer. Okay. Now, let me see one more question. Question number 6. Okay, question number 6. Question number 6. Question number 9, stop question 6. 1 plus I whole cube divided by 1 minus I cube. Just simplify it. It's a very simple question. Okay, question asked to find the simplification answer. We can use, replace this, break this I cube as I square multiply I because we have a value of I square. Okay, now let's consider this is z equals to this expression. That equals to 1 plus I whole cube divided by 1 minus. Now break this power, I square dot I. I cube is there, break the power, I square dot I. I square means minus 1. Okay? And this is 1 plus I whole cube divided by I square is minus 1. Then minus and minus 1. The product is plus 1 plus I. Okay, and this whole term and this cube get cancelled on square set. Now that equals to 1 plus I whole square. Now use the square identities, square algebraic identities to get their final expression. Now this is a square plus b square plus 2ab. Okay. Now this is equal to 1, I square means minus 1 plus 2i. Now this is 1 minus 1 is 0 and this is 2i. Then in the standard form you can write 0 plus 2i. Okay. Now let me see other questions. Now question number 7. Okay, question number 7. 9 sub question 7. Okay, I'm going to do directly. Z equals to 1 plus I divided by 1 minus I. Question asks to say whether it is integer or not. Okay.